by saying, listen, you have been caught up in a deception. You have been led astray by people who are under the same grip of sin as you. This woman does not represent hope or change or truth. This is the blind leading the blind.
Actually, I can see.
This is the spiritually blind leading the spiritually blind. Christ came to give life to you. You can have life abundantly. He wants to set you free from homosexuality. It's a trap. You weren't born that way. You were born in sin, and you choose what style of sin you want to define your life by, because you have no other way to define your life. You have no other way to define your life except by what you know is the closest to your heart. If you have a sinful heart, sin is all you know. And that's how you define yourself. You can define yourself as a liar. You can define yourself as a fornicator. You can define yourself as a hater or a murderer. But I'll tell you what, hatred is defined as having apathy. We are not apathetic to your condition. We are caring for your souls when we tell you that you did not deserve to have your father, your mother molest you, or that Christian who was a hypocrite burn you for you to make this decision going down the path to choose homosexuality. Here is a series of choices. There is no proof that you were born this way, but there's plenty of proof that we're all born sinners. You need to repent of your sin and find true life. I am the sinner. We're all sinners before God. We need to be set free from our sins. There's hope.
Your God is the sinner.
Oh, sir, you're speaking foolishly.
Your
God is the sinner. Oh, there's gibberish coming out of your mouth. I can't understand it. I can't understand it.
Gay is good. Gay is godly. You are not.
The only gay, the only happy way to be is set free from your sins. Set free from your sins. I still sin, but you know what? Oh no, how am I sinning? I couldn't hear. I'm honestly, I couldn't hear you. How many of you with a friend who's addicted to drugs would have an intervention for your friend? How many of you would be concerned that your friend was addicted to drugs and you would talk to them about it? We see people addicted to sex. We see people addicted to drugs, addicted to sin. The roller coaster of emotion that you go on trying to find true love. And we are having an intervention for you right now, whether you like it or not. True love warns of impending danger, and the judgment of God is coming against the sons and the daughters of disobedience. The Holy Spirit has got your heart. He wants you to be saved. Note, and they play these tunes in harmony, but you know what? The Bible is so something that most of you probably have not tried to read seriously, consider as funny. The Bible is God's message to us, telling us about how we can be saved from our own sinful nature. If you're not following the book, you're going to be lost. I'll take a flower from you. Thank you. The Lord created this flower right here.
That ain't got it.
You know what? The Lord wants you to be His daughter. The Lord wants to see you bloom just like this flower. Just like this flower. This was watered. It was planted in good soil. If you keep yourself in soil that doesn't have any nutrients in it, you're going to be a withered flower. God wants you to be nourished by the Holy Spirit, by truth. And we're trying to bring truth to you today. You know what? Don't think that this is chance that you've come down here in the rain. And you're hearing the gospel of Jesus Christ, that He can be your Savior as He was my Savior, as He was my Father's Savior, as He was Mark's Savior. You can be set free and you can share that salvation with us. We can be in that fellowship of people in the heavens who are praising the Lord. You're either going to know Him as Lord or you're going to know Him as judge.
You know what, sir?
I don't want to know God as judge because the judgment of the Lord is righteous. And I am unrighteous. I am an unrighteous man. I don't deserve the mercy of God. You don't deserve the mercy of God. We all deserve hell. We all deserve hell, but you know what? Grace is a free gift. Grace is given to you because God's kindness is leading you to repentance right now. Whoever you are who are listening right now, whoever you are who are read, go to homosexuals.com, and you're going to have some time where your conscience actually makes its way through all of the junk that you put on top of it, all of the junk that you tried to stuff your conscience down with. It's going to let a little bit of it up, and when it does, you need to turn to Christ. You need to turn to Christ. Don't mock Him. Oh, don't mock Him.
There was a thing in Cambridge, in the high school.